Good morning, students. Welcome to Complex Analysis Live Lectures. In this class, we'll discuss what is meant by stereographic projection and a Riemann sphere. And from that, we'll define or understand what is meant by a neighborhood at point at infinity. Okay. Right. So first, we'll define what is meant by extended complex plane. So extended complex plane is nothing but complex plane together with point at infinity. This is called, there is a point at infinity. So complex plane together with this point, if you consider, then we will call it that as a extended complex plane. Sometimes this will be denoted by C star. So if you see C star, it is C union this point at infinity. Okay. Now, to come to this, what is meant by stereographic projection and a Riemann sphere, try to understand. Suppose, assume that we have a complex plane. We have a complex plane passing through an unit sphere equator, passing through the equator of this unit sphere. So let me draw that one. Okay, and this is complex plane, so if you want, you put it like this. Okay, fine. Now, so just understand, if you want to understand, take a sphere. Okay, you have a, just take, assume you have a ball. Then you take a paper, and that paper, you try to put it in the center of that sphere. Okay, equator, it is passing through the equator of this one. So this is... whatever center we have here is origin, and you call it this pole, this north pole, you denote by N. Now, the idea is, it is just like assume things. You take a paper, taking the paper, you try to fold it in sphere, in try to fold it in corners. That means you bring it that entire paper to up to one corner. Try to stick the corners of that paper to one point. Then obviously what we get when you try to fold a paper in such a way that all the corners, whatever we are having to that paper, bring it to one point. No? Say you call it that as N. If we try to bring it to that one point, what you will get? You take a paper, try to fold that paper. All the corners, you bring it to one point. What you will get? You will get just like a sphere or not? At least close to ball. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? So the idea is the complex plane and the sphere has some projection. They have some relation. So what you can do is we can understand. You take a point. You take some point. Say suppose call it this is Z. Okay? You have a point Z on complex plane. Then try to... You have this point N on this sphere. Try to connect these two points. What we will get? So just to understand, you write this as like dotted one, and this is call it P, and this one. So I'm trying to join N and Z. It will intersect exactly at one place of that sphere. Yes or no? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. So you take N is fixed, and you take any point in the complex plane Z, try to join N and Z. Okay, just like you assume that you have a rope, try to tie N and Z with a rope. Then you can see that that will go just like take a needle. needle and try to pause that from N and Z, you will see that it will touch or cut that sphere at only one point. Are you following? Just like you take a soft ball, okay, and take a large a pin, long one, and try to push from N to Z, then you will see that it will cut at only one point. That you call it as a P. That means every point on the complex plane Z, this is actually mapping to this P. If you change another one, it will be another point. If you change another one, it will be another point. Is that clear? So every point in the complex plane is mapped to some point on the sphere. Yes or no? Every point Z in the complex plane is mapped to, you can call it unique point, because if Z is different, then that P is different, right? Unique point P on this unit sphere. And the converse is also true. Say I can say and vice versa also. That means what? If you take any point on this sphere, right? Then if you join this one, this N and that point, it will cut this complex plane at some point. Is this clear? Yes or no? So either you take point from a complex plane and try to join Z and N, it will cut one point. Or you take a point on a sphere, that unit sphere, and try to join those two points, extend to that complex plane, it will cut at one point. Right? Yes or no? Any problem? So if you take any point on the sphere, so any point on the sphere other than N maps to a point in the complex plane, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now what about N? Can we map N to a point in complex plane? Because the idea is here, if you take a point different from N, then that these two points we get exactly one unique line passing through that. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
But when we have N,
yes, sir.
Now take on this sphere, N is there. For that N, we cannot have a unique line. Are you following? If you are not understood, you tell. See, for all these points, whatever you take on this sphere, what you can do? You can join these points with N, you will get a unique line. Right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, because there is already N is there, and with that N, given any other point in this sphere, we are trying to join line and it cuts the complex plane at exactly one point. Now, what about N? Only that point N. So, assume that other than N, every other point is mapped. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, what about
N? Yes, sir.
This N remains. Clear? Why that N is remaining? It is not mapped to any other point in complex plane. Because you don't have a point, unique point, other than N. That other than N is already mapped. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
So this N, we have to map it to somewhere else. That means other than N, everything is mapped to Z. And every point in Z is mapped to that sphere other than N. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So So now this n we will map to, so this n whatever we are having, we will map to this point at infinity. Okay, so therefore this C union infinity, that means extended complex plane and this unit sphere has one-to-one correspondence or not? So we map n, that north pole, to this point at infinity. So every point in the unit sphere other than n is mapped to complex plane, and that point n is mapped to point at infinity. Is that clear?
Yes.
So therefore there is a implies, hence there is a one-to-one correspondence. There is a one-to-one correspondence between extended complex plane to the unit sphere. Is that clear? Anyone having difficulty? What is this one? Everyone at home, try to do this as a small project. Take a paper and take a transparent ball, transparent one, and try to join with different. Okay. So you take whatever nariyal rehte na, nariyal ka leaves, from that you take that stick so that you can put it inside that sphere. And you see that if your z is different, that intersection point of intersection is different, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So in this process,
yes, sir,
whatever we are getting this sphere, that means you take z together with infinity and you project that into unit sphere, whatever that is called is Riemann sphere. Okay, so this sphere whatever we are getting is called Riemann sphere, and this process whatever correspondence we are calling, and this correspondence is called stereography projection. Stereographic projection. That means we are projecting the points on the extended complex plane to that unit sphere, and the vice versa. That means a point on the unit sphere, you can project it to the extended complex plane, right? So just to understand thing better, let me show you this one. Can you see this screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is the sphere which we are talking about, which is passing through the equator. Okay, so you can see that sphere, and this is what I was talking. You take a paper and you take a transparent ball, cut it at the center and put half sphere on paper, above the paper, and half sphere below the paper. Okay, right? Now just take a point, for example this d is a point on the unit this d is a point on the complex plane, yes or no? Can you see this one?
No, sir.
What, you can't see the image?
No, sir.
Yeah. Now, if you see this one, this is the sphere I was talking about, and you have a paper which is complex plane, right? And this complex plane, yes, is passing through the equator of this unit sphere, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I'm rotating, yes, so that you can see the thing. So you put it, you take a paper and take a transparent one ball, you cut in the center and put half above the paper and half below the paper, right?
Yes, sir.
Now you take this point D. This point D, can you see? Now I'm rotating.
Yes.
So the moment, yes, I change D, that here this point F is changing. Okay. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now this is the D where you can see I am changing. Now if you take this D and I am this E, whatever E, it is actually N. Okay. This D and E, you join the line. If we join the line, this D and E, okay, it is cutting this spear. It is intersecting this spear at this point F. Right? Is this clear? Let me zoom in a little bit.
Yes, sir.
So this is the point D, and this is the point N, you can call it. Okay. Now this D and N, if you join, what it intersect is this point F. Now you carefully observe, when I rotate this D, when I change this position D, the position of F is changing, right? That means for yes, every sir. Complex yes, number is mapped to some unique point in this unit sphere. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can suppose take K, you see that whatever this K is mapping to that point M. That K is mapped to point M, right? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now what observe you can do is this point, take this point D. If you take this point D, then if you move this point D, okay, which is moving this F, is moving, that means when I take this D to far away from this unit circle, that means away from this sphere, when a point is close to this sphere, okay, you can see that F is below to this, that means that F is close to that equator. If I take this D little far, far from that sphere, then it is going outside that. For that, let me show another picture. You can understand better. Suppose you take this. Now this is a point. Yes or no? Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
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 Now this Z2, you take this point, say suppose Z2. Okay, this Z2 I will bring it close to this sphere. And this is a point Z1, I will bring it little away from, I will take it away from this sphere. There are two points, one is Z2, another one is Z1. Right? Z1 is far away from this unit sphere or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And Z2
yes,
sir. Is nearer to this sphere, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So what do you have observed?
Yes, sir.
If Z1 is far from this sphere, outside sphere, then the point of intersection, that is zeta 1 and zeta 2, right? This point of intersection zeta 1, what you observe? It is close to N.
Yes, sir.
Whereas
yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is far from N.
Yes.
And that is, imagine when you have a point, okay, in the complex plane, which is far away from that unit circle, whatever inside, this is unit circle. That means whatever plane is cutting, see, whatever plane cuts this sphere, that is actually inside that is unit circle. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
If yes, you take the unit circle in the complex plane, then points outside that complex unit circle, some point close to that unit circle and some point which is far away from that unit circle. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
What we have observed?
Yes, sir.
The point which is away from, far away from this unit circle mod z is equal to 1 is close to, that is means that point is mapped a point which is close to N. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And a point
yes, sir.
Is near
yes, sir.
This unit circle, but outside, is mapping to this Z, zeta 2, which is
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Points near to infinity are not. And usually what we call it is a neighborhood. Neighborhood means neighborhood of a point is nothing but points which are very, very close to that point. That point. Yes or no? So therefore,
yes, sir.
A point which is very, very close to this will be mapped to neighborhood of infinity. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So we can define now what is meant by a neighborhood of infinity using this one. Okay. So they are precisely all points which are exterior to this circle, which is a large circle, right? Or this way you can write in terms of, because when we define neighborhood, we take epsilon, which is greater than zero, a small number, right? So whenever we want to take a small number and we want to have a large number here, how you will do? If I take 1 by epsilon, when epsilon is very small, then 1 by epsilon will become large and larger. Right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, we
yes, sir.
Define now what is meant by neighborhood of, you can call it epsilon neighborhood. Epsilon neighborhood of point at infinity. Okay. So, from this, what we have observed? All points, this set Z, such that, which is an exterior point of this circle. That means mod Z greater than, exterior means greater than, 1 by epsilon. How many of you understood this is the called epsilon neighborhood of infinity? All points Z whose value, that means whose distance from this Z to 0, that means mod Z, is greater than 1 by epsilon. Whether this one and this one make sense or not? Are they both are similar?
Yes.
Because we are trying to define what are all complex points which are neighborhood of infinity. Even though infinity is not a complex number, it is an extended, it is a point of in extended complex plane. Right? Now, what are all complex numbers which are in the neighborhood of infinity? How you can understand this? If a point which is far away from that circle, they are close to n, so therefore this point, whatever this point, is mapped to neighborhood of infinity. That we can understand, right? Any problem?
Yes, sir.
So what we have observed here is, what are all points which are mapped near to n? The points exterior to this huge circle, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So how will you get a huge circle when you're given epsilon which is greater than zero? By simply taking 1 by epsilon. Are you following? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So epsilon neighborhood of infinity means all points Z such that mod Z is greater than 1 by epsilon. If I give some epsilon, then I will know what is meant by that. So epsilon is however small, then you get this unit circle, not unit circle, mod Z greater than 1 by epsilon. That is a bigger and bigger. So you are taking points outside that circle. Clear? Any problem?
Yes.
So now what we have understood, we have understood what is meant by a new point, point at infinity, and neighborhood. Given epsilon, epsilon neighborhood of infinity. Okay? Yes or no? If we recall,
yes, sir.
What is meant by epsilon neighborhood? Epsilon neighborhood of a complex number Z naught. It is simply all points Z such that mod Z minus Z naught is less than epsilon. Is that clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And epsilon neighborhood of infinity is nothing but all Z such that whose value mod z is greater than 1 by epsilon, right? Now using this epsilon neighborhood of infinity, we'll prove the following result. You can call it as theorem, which says that if z naught and w naught, z plane and w plane, okay, are points in z and w planes, then of course respectively, then the one can limit of f of z as z tending to z naught is equal to infinity. That means the limit of this f of z approaches infinity as z tending to z naught. So far we don't know how to calculate this one, because this infinity is involving. So this we will give in terms of, so this is same as saying that, so you can understand f of z tends to infinity. So which will tends to zero? When f of z tends to infinity, what is the value which we can make sure that will be tends to zero? If something is large, then you want to get something is very small, what you do? You reciprocal, right?
Yes, reciprocal.
Here I already said, if epsilon, you want large number and epsilon is given a small number, you take 1 by epsilon. Yes or no? That is limit of 1 by f of z as z tending to z naught. This value should be equal to 0. Yes or no?
0.
Yes.
Now, the left-hand side involves infinity. That means extended complex plane. Whereas right-hand side, whatever you are having here, if you observe this, we know already we can find such everything. There is no infinity. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
This limit we can handle. So if we, whenever we want to show something is infinity, then you show this is equal to 0. Right? That is the meaning of this. Okay. Now, second one. Similarly, limit of f of z. Now, z tending to infinity. That means z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity. When a z is in neighborhood of infinity, if this value is some complex number, say w naught, if and only if, how we can write? Can somebody tell? Limit of f of, when z is in neighborhood of infinity, then if you take 1 by z, then where it should be?
N.
It should be value, this value should be equal to w naught. Are you following? This is same as saying that.
Yes, sir.
See, try to understand. This z tend to infinity, we don't know this behavior properly. So, whereas we know z tending to 0, we know it. Right? So, as z tending to infinity, f of z, we want to find, is same as z tending to 0, f of 1 by z. Is this clear? Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Z is a huge number. Then we are finding f of z is same as take a z which is very very close to 0, you find f of 1 by z, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Similarly, what is the other option? The other one is limit f of z. Now this z also tending to infinity and this value also infinity is same as, how we will change? Again, this z tending to infinity, we will change it to z tending to 0. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, wherever f of z is there, it will be f of 1 by z. Just like this one. Right? Now, here equal to infinity is there. How you will do that? If you use 1? This you write here 0. Right? Then it is same as 1 by f of something. Yes or no? But
yes,
now z is tending to infinity, so I can write here 1 by z. Is this clear? Left hand side, if you observe this left hand side, they all involve at one or two places infinity, point at infinity. Whereas this right hand side, nowhere it involves point at infinity. Right? So if f of z is tending to infinity is same as 1 by f of z tending to 0. So is z tending to infinity same as saying that 1 by z tends to 0. Are you following?
Yes.
How you will prove this? The proof is not at all difficult. So let's prove this. One, this limit f of z, limit f of z as z tending to z naught, this is equal to infinity. By definition, so this infinity, you simply call it as w naught. Okay, that w naught is either a complex number or infinite. That means w naught, if you call it just this is like a w naught, it is an extended complex number. Now, what is the definition? How we have defined? What is meant by saying that limit of f of z is equal to something?
Mod f of z minus infinity is less than epsilon.
But you should not write mod f of z minus infinity, right? Here I have defined what is meant by epsilon neighborhood of infinity. In this set, there is no infinity. We are not writing z minus infinity. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Some z is in the epsilon neighborhood of infinity if mod z is greater than 1 by epsilon. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
So how you will write? Here, f of z, 1 by f of z should be greater than epsilon. So given epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta greater than 0 such that, first I will write in words, then you can understand, such that this f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity. Is this clear or not? Whenever z is in delta neighborhood of z naught. Is this clear? Is this clear or not? What is the definition of this one? Given any epsilon, there is a delta such that this f of z is in this neighborhood whenever z minus z naught is in this neighborhood. Are you following or not?
Yes, yes.
If you have not understood, yes, you sir. Tell. This is the entire thing. Now, right hand side, you try to simplify. This is same as saying that for all epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0 such that, what is the definition of saying that f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity? When we say that some z is in the neighborhood, if mod of that value is greater than 1 by epsilon. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
So what we will get here?
Yes, sir.
What is mod 1 by f of z? This value is greater than epsilon. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Whenever z is in neighborhood of delta neighborhood of z naught means what? Z minus z naught is less than delta. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And we want to prove that limit of this one is equal to 0. Right? Yes or no? So z minus z naught is less than delta, you don't need to change. Only thing is modulus of 1 by f of z minus 0 is less than epsilon we want. And that is same as this one. If you rewrite this, what you will have? Oh, sorry. We have mentioned here wrong. Nobody has pointed out this. Here, mod z is greater than 1 by epsilon. Right? This nobody has pointed out. This is wrong. By definition, mod f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity. That means mod f of z is greater than 1 by epsilon. Simply listening, you should correct it, right? Okay. Now, this is same as saying that mod 1 by f of z is less than epsilon. These two are same under not?
Yes, sir.
Of course, we have to make sure that f of z is non-zero, right? Okay. That means f of z is non-zero, then 1 by f of z, it makes sense. Whenever mod z minus z naught is less than delta. Is this clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But this is same as saying that limit of 1 by f of z as z tending to z naught is equal to 0. Right? That proves first one. Yes or no? Let's prove second one.
Yes, so that sir.
You can understand somewhat better. What is second one? Limit of f of z as z tending to infinity is w naught. So limit of f of z as z tending to infinity, this value is given to be w naught. If and only if, can somebody tell what is, how you can write definition? For all epsilon, that means given epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta greater than 0 such that f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of w naught, f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of w naught whenever z is in what?
Z is
delta
neighborhood.
Delta neighborhood of what? Which point?
Infinity.
Very good. Infinity. Now you rewrite this in terms of points. How you can write statement? For all epsilon, there exists a greater delta. There exists delta such that. What is meant by saying that f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of w naught?
Mod
f of z minus w naught is less than epsilon. Whenever. What is meant by saying that z is in delta neighborhood of infinity? Whenever mod z is greater than 1 by delta. Is this clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If you want, you remove here and you write here. Whenever mod z is greater than 1 by delta. Now go back here. What we want to prove? We want to somehow prove that this f of 1 by z equal to w naught whenever z is in neighborhood of 0, right? That means somehow we should get mod z is less than delta and mod f of 1 by z minus w naught is less than epsilon, right? I am already said here, we want somehow, this is f of z minus w naught is there, right? Here we want f of 1 by z minus w naught. So what replacement we can do here? In place of z, what we require? 1 by z we require. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
So replace
yes,
z by 1 by z in the above one. What we will get? What we get? This is same as saying that for all epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta greater than 0 such that mod f of 1 by z minus w naught is less than epsilon. Okay, whenever mod 1 by z is greater than 1 by delta. Are you following? Yes or no?
Okay. Yes, sir.
That means my new z is 1 by z. That's all. Now you simplify this. The first part is no need to simplify anything. It is already there. That means mod f of 1 by z minus w naught is less than epsilon. We don't need to disturb this. Whenever 1 by mod z is greater than 1 by delta is same as saying that mod z is less than delta. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But this is precisely limit of f of 1 by z as z tending to 0, because here z minus 0 is there, right? This is same as w. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now third one, you prove it, exercise I will give. Okay? Again, what you have to do here? Third one, this z is also in delta neighborhood of infinity and f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So when you are proving this, sir, make sure one time you will replace z by 1 by z. Okay. And are you following? Any problem? Can you do it? Third one? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. We'll try.
So you try. Yes, everyone try. If you are not getting, again, every day I repeat same question and I never get any answer in next class. Right? When I give an exercise, that means if you do it, definitely you will understand. I did two. And same way you have to do the third one. Z is in neighborhood of infinity, of course, delta neighborhood, and f of z is in epsilon neighborhood of infinity. You write those meanings and you see whether you will get this or not. Yes or no? Right hand side, what we should get? Mod z should be less than delta, and mod 1 by f of modulus of 1 by f of 1 by z should be less than epsilon. Okay? So only those two you should bring it from this one. And it is very easy. Okay? So I'll leave it that as an exercise. You do it. We'll just see an example how we can find using this result some problem. That means whenever you want to show something is infinity, you calculate this, and if this is zero, this value will be infinite. Okay? So just take one example. Let me write that. Then we'll discuss. So show that one is limit of iz plus 3 upon z plus 1 as z tending to minus 1. This value is infinite. Okay? And second one, limit of 2z plus I upon z plus 1 as z tending to infinity. This show that this value is 2. And third one, limit 2z cube minus 1 upon z square plus 1 as z tending to infinity to show that this is infinite. That means I have taken each one example having limit is infinity and z tending to infinity, z as well as limit both tending to infinity. Right? Now, if we want to show this first one, what we want to show? Just show that this is just like your f of z. Okay? So, how you will calculate this one? To show this, it is enough. So, let me take another color. Enough to show what? Limit. Whatever you are having, this is z, then it is 1 by f of z. So, which is same as z plus 1 by iz plus 3 as z tending to minus 1, show that this is equal to 0. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You see the first one. If we want to show that this is infinity, z tending to z naught, 1 by f of z, this value equal to 0. Okay? Similarly, now it is easy to 0. You can see that when you substitute z minus 1, this is minus 1 plus 1, which is 0 upon a non-zero value, which is 0. Right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is clear.
Yes, sir.
And now, how you will do this? If we want to calculate such thing, what we want to calculate? This is same as saying that limit of, instead of z tending to 0, you take z tending to, instead of z tending to infinity, you take z tending to 0. But wherever f of z is there, you have to find f of 1 by z. That is second one. Are you following? Yes or no?
Yes,
so
yes,
this
sir.
Is same as saying that wherever z is there,
yes, sir.
1 by z will show that this value is 2. And you can check that you can check that 2 plus j I times z and 1 plus I times z will cancel, and when you substitute 2 times z tending to 0, 2 by 1 you will get. Is this clear? So this is also clear. Now what about third one? How we want to calculate this? Z tending to 0, and this is your f of z, it is 1 by f of 1 by z. That means this. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Show that this is equal to 0. We want to show that this is equal to 0. And you can check that this limit is actually 0. Okay? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So please go through this. What is the concept of this Riemann sphere? What is meant by stereographic projection? How the concept of neighborhood of infinity can be understood from this? Okay, then how we can relate the limit involving infinity in another one which is not involving infinity, right? Any problem? So you have to only solve this third one, and if you have a difficulty, definitely I'll explain. But if you don't ask, I don't. We'll go to next section. Okay. So next class we'll see after limit. The next one is continuous. Okay, continuity of a complex function. Okay, that means function of a complex variable. Right. We'll stop here.